Today I am in Northern California looking for one of the many species of trapdoor spiders that you can find up here. And this one is Aptostichus stanfordianus, one of the tougher species to find, but I'm confident we can find a few. So I'm headed to a creek in a conifer forest that isn't too far away from here. These trapdoor spiders are from the family Eustenidae, the wafer-lid trapdoor spiders. So the trapdoors are a bit more concealed than usual. This is a night-trained millipede, Harpaphe, heydeniana. Most of that blue coloration comes from the UV light from the sun that's hitting them. Same thing happens with scorpions oftentimes when you flip them under debris. Usually these are almost jet black. And this is a species of flat-backed millipede. Flat-backed millipedes are polydesmids. And this is a species that's mainly found in redwood forests. This guy was just walking out and about like they do sometimes. They're usually nocturnal, so it's a bit unusual to see this one during the day. Looks like we have turret spiders here, Atypoides riversi. There's a little one right there, which isn't very surprising at all. We have a medium one and an adult. The first video I ever did on this channel was on this species. I managed to lure one of these turret spiders out by brushing it with a piece of grass, and then I pinched the burrow for it to sort of move out. So here it is. This one's a subadult. This is just a gopher snake kind of hanging out in the grass there. Getting some sun, I assume. Not too far away. You almost got there. Unlike most snakes that tend to calm down the longer you have them in your hand, this guy is wiggling more and more the longer I have him. This is probably the most restless gopher snake I've ever seen. I'll let it go back to where it was. I was scratching at the ground and managed to find this little guy, which is a little Aptostichus stanfordianus sling. This little one seems to be 1/10 to 1/15 the size of a full-grown adult. Just a molt or two away from being a sling. These can't really dig burrows at this time of the year because the ground is quite tough. So this little guy is coming with me. I found a piece of dirt here that perfectly demonstrates the why that you find in a lot of wafer-lid trapdoor spider burrows. So there we have the main shaft. That's where it goes back towards the spider. And here it goes towards the door, towards the surface. And that's the side area. You can see it goes fairly straight through on the main shaft, and the side hole sort of just juts off. This piece of wood just fell off this log, and there was a beetle here. At first I thought it was Temnoschila, but it looks like it's one of our native stag beetles. And this is Platysirus oreganus. And I've raised a few stag beetle species before in the past, namely Lucanus, but the larva of this species here I've found to be next to impossible to raise to adulthood, unfortunately. Looks like there was another one, another male, hiding up in this crack here that I hadn't noticed previously. The habitat for this beetle tends to be quite consistently areas with rotting logs next to streams and heavily forested areas. As unusual as that other night-trained millipede may have been, there's another one right here, properly in the sun too. I guess where it's shaded enough, generally, they don't have a problem with being out. They also have very few predators, being as toxic as they are to consume. They have hydrogen cyanide that they can pump out from between their body segments.
There's a newt walking around out here. I wonder if that's his burrow. Doesn't really seem to know what he's doing either.
Here's a burrow right here, but this one belongs to Aliatypus californicus and not the Aptostichus that we're looking for. So I'll leave it alone. Here we have a few Aptostichus stanfordianus. I think that's a burrow right there. Yeah, that's a door. I'm not sure which way it flips. There you go. There it is. There's a little one right here. There's one that was, I don't know. It looks kind of screwed up, but, oh no, that's a turret spider. Yeah, I think that's a turret spider burrow. And then up here, getting eroded, is another one right there. And there's one in here. There's probably a few more that I'm missing, but that's just from a quick glance. And there's a lot of poison oak here, which I don't want to get covered in, so I think I'll skip this bunch. All right, I've relocated to another area that I've seen this species in the past, because in the other ditch where I was, there was way too many mosquitoes, because I'm pretty sure there was some stagnant water across some parts of that stream. Looks like we have a door right here. Unfortunately, it goes straight down to the ground, so it's going to be a bit of a pain to excavate, but it looks like a pretty good one, belonging to an adult or a subadult. It hopefully doesn't descend very far. I've noticed that in this area, there are rocks in the ground, not too many, but if there are too many, it'll be pretty tough on my pick. See, stuff like that. And it'll take much longer to dig through. Here is the door. Here's my mattock. And you guys are about to see just how tough the ground is. Just as I've done in the past, I'm digging a little trench here, and then I'm going to split the dirt that is between the burrow and the trench, and that way it'll be pretty easy to unearth the spider that's in there. But this time, the ground is so hard that I think I'm going to get some water and pour it in here for it to soften up. I have a large container of water here, and now it's time to soften up the ground. And I'm not sure how long I'll have to wait for all that to percolate, but it already seems to be going down quite quickly. I have waited a while after pouring in the water outdoors here, and it seems to be mostly all soaked into the soil. So I'm going to start excavating again. Here's our trapdoor. This is the burrow back there. Very nice one. Let me see if I can open this one. There you have it. Looks like while I was digging that one out, I intercepted a slightly smaller one, which I didn't really want to do, but here we are. So once I dig that one up, I will dig this one up as well. We have reached the end of the burrow, and there's a spider down there. Let's see. There, you can see it. And that is the spider that we are looking for. And here it is. This one is a bit smaller than I was expecting. It seems to be a subadult, and I was expecting that to be an adult, given the size of the door. That being said, I've only ever seen two adults in my entire life, so I guess it is pretty tough to see a full-grown one, and I don't really know why that is. To make matters even worse, both of the ones that I found were found on accident, so I've never set out to find an adult and been successful. Doesn't seem too concerned with biting, so I'm gonna see if I can handle it. Here it is again, and this isn't the first time that this species has shown up in one of my videos, but I thought I would do an entire video dedicated to these since they are quite a cool species. Here's the spider from the second door I dug up. Unfortunately, it is not an Aptostichus stanfordianus. This is a Promyrmekiaphila clathrata, which admittedly has a very similar looking burrow. And the very annoying thing about these is they're more common than stanfordianus, and they're sympatric. That being said, it is quite a cool species. While I was walking along, I found a false tarantula burrow, and I managed to lure it out. And this is the first time in my life that I've been able to lure one out during the day. Typically, it's pretty straightforward to do at night if you can locate some burrows during the warm months. But during the day, this one must have been a bit desperate, which is kind of bizarre considering that it looks to be quite well fed. And of course, especially after luring them out of a burrow, it's next to impossible to handle them without getting mauled. They are quite defensive. Here is our next burrow here. Seems to be about the same size as the last one. I've already made a trench, and a while ago I put water in here so that it would have time to soak in. And I think it is ready to dig up, just like the last one.
kind of following the same process. I hit the entrance off. I wanted to do it more cleanly, but that obviously failed. Here was another small part of it that's supposed to go right there. I'm gonna keep it anyway and see what I can do with it, because these spiders are oftentimes very good at fixing burrows. And our burrow is right here. We have our second spider in here. There it is. And this one seems to be about the same size as the other one. This one was much more straightforward to dig up. The burrow is not long at all, 20 centimeters or so. And I believe the reason that these smaller trapdoor spiders, or these subadults, are showing up in these larger burrows, or burrows with larger doors, is because, scientifically, they have a fat butt, and they're aware to some degree that they are about to molt and become larger, and therefore they need to make their burrow larger before they molt instead of after. It looks like he's about to go into my sleeve. And in the western mountains of the Bay Area, this is the only species of Aptostichus that lives here, and only the second species of wafer-lid trapdoor spider that lives here. The other one being the Promyrmekiaphila clathrata spider that I showed you, the dark one. And if you're wondering what the niche partitioning between this species and the St. Patrick clathrata is, I'm pretty sure this one just takes up the drier microclimates, and that's why clathrata seems to be quite a bit more common. Speaking in fairly loose general terms, the species does have a fairly wide distribution, but gets replaced in the north by Aptostichus Barack Obama, in the south by Angelina Jolie, and in the east by Asmodeus, and in the west by sand dune species. While I was filming this little guy, I noticed another trapdoor here. I'm not gonna dig it up. It's a bit smaller than the last two, and I'm pretty much done anyway. And a little bit further out, we have a very old one, long abandoned. It's been filled up with debris as well. There's another trapdoor right there. The spider that's in it is probably about the same size as this one too. Let me just open this one up so you can see the door. There you have it. Well, that will be all for this video. Unfortunate that we didn't find any adults, but that's okay. Thank you for watching.